Lee is on. Well, we were anyway. There we go. Ultra wide dragon. Yeah. Emma. Yeah, his screen is my monitor is very large. Hello, by the way, person. I'm not sure who you are, but I'm very happy to see you. That's the wrong door. Salutations, dearest viewers, and welcome to the City of Sanctuary. We built this city on rock and roll. Hey, Logan. I apologize in advance for all the gross allergy noises I'm going to be making, by the way. Because, by the way, I have bad allergies, and they are always the worst, like, before, or noon-ish, and a bit after. So, yeah, just apologies in advance for all the gross allergy noises you guys are going to be hearing. All four of you. All right, well, if anyone has any questions about the City of Sanctuary, this would probably be the time to ask. Sans Bad Time 15. Hello there. I have no idea who you are, but I'm happy you stopped by. I am Lord and Lady. Well, Zoro, eh. Oh. Okay, so this is a bit of a long story, but just try to keep up with me, Logan. For a while, I've been fantasizing about being able to create a city that's a safe haven and for her outcasts, like the LGBT community, and just other people who are treated unfairly by society. A sanctuary for the downtrodden. And that's where the name comes from. And frankly, I haven't come up with a better one. Oh, I mean, you're free, YouTube. I'll probably put it to work in the more affluent parts of... I'll probably put it in the more affluent parts of town. Like, this is actually, like, essentially the free housing district. That might just be my connection. And it also might just be the way I speak. Like, I have a rather awkward way of speaking. Like, my voice is just... Like, how do I put this? It's hard to explain, but like... My voice just kind of does this thing where it sounds like I'm cutting it. Oh, sort of. It's weird. Heard kind of hard to explain. And it just makes me sound weirdly unnatural. So yeah, it's partially my connection and partially just the way I speak. I apologize if it gets distracting. I sound a lot better when I'm reading from a script. This is a stream. Obviously, I don't have a script. You know, I never really think about using lodestones as decorations since they are an extremely prohibitively expensive block to be using for that. But that being said, you aren't wrong. This does look nice. Excuse me. So, yeah, thank you. Sans, you sure aren't giving me a bad time. Alright, we have a kitchen. And, I should show you guys the apartment complex. Because this apartment complex really just epitomizes his weirdly thoughtless I can be at times. While also kind of being perfect in its own way. You'll see what I mean. First of all, I would like to thank, I think it was Vintage Beef, or maybe it was, one of the other, or Hermits, like maybe Beat. I was like, I don't remember which Hermit, but I remember watching one of the Hermits, and they like, that if you put a trap door on top of a piece of scaffolding, it looks exactly like a chair. Brown mushroom blocks might not be a bad idea. But anyway, this is the average room in this apartment complex, essentially. And yeah, I know it's not much. It's not supposed to be much. Aw, thank you, Logan. I realized a bit too late that I didn't really give these apartments ways to have bathrooms or toilets, so, there's a public toilet block here, which I just realized I forgot to lock it up on the inside. Oopsie doopsie. Eh, might as well make it consistent. There. And there's also a nice big public bathhouse. Here's what the average room looks like in the bathhouse. Using banners to look like towels, which I think is a really neat idea. There is, however, one and private bath for people who have a bit more money to splash around. And these are meant to be lockers. Isn't that lovely? And of course, even in the poorer parts of town, still neat area is to just kind of hang around park type areas or plazas like this. As someone who has a bit too much of an obsession with Mesopotamia, I agree. Mud bricks are underrated. Oh, good grief. Sorry, guys. Phone. Okay, B-dubs. That has got to be the wackiest thing I've read all day. Grant, and it's probably the wackiest thing I'm going to read all day. So, congratulations on that. Like, my day practically just started, and you've already given me something, hey, more wacky to read, and I'm probably going to read all day. Take that however you wish to take it. Actually, a chain might not be a bad idea. You've got some really neat idea. It's knocking around in that head of your there's sans under tail. Wait, that's not quite right. There. What was I doing again? Right, chains. Okay, you know what? Yeah, I like that. I typically use brewing stands as like kitchen decor, essentially. I really hope you're around when I start getting to the more affluent parts of town. You are going to be extremely helpful. Oh, whenever I get around to that. Well, one of the main things I plan on doing is trying to use, that's a little embarrassed to say it, but, like, one of the things I kind of want to do for the more affluent areas is used particularly polished diorite. It, like, I know diorite is kind of a taboo block to you. This for a lot of Minecrafters, and that's why I'm a bit embarrassed to say it. Like, just a lot of people dismiss Dyra as the bird poop block, thanks to Iskal. Oh god, wet sponge, that is a taboo block. Yeah, I kind of want to do something a bit. Hipla. Heck, mine colony. His New Caledonia. A palette for the more affluent parts of town. If you have no idea what I'm talking about. Oh, I mean, that's fair enough. If not everyone plays with mine colonies. Not everyone plays with mods, period, really, but you know what I mean. But yeah, just mine colonies feels like one of the more obscure or just mods out there. Or like, it's nowhere near as big as something like Create or whatever. I did not see all of that. Hang on. Yeah, I can imagine that looking like Oreos. Okay, who pinged me? No, just that one server. Hey, more power to you, man. I completely understand. There's a certain challenge that I like about how building things in survival mode, but a creative mode is just really good if you have an idea and want to mess around with it. Spruce doors are really nice for bathrooms, and so are dark oak for that matter. Just any of the doors that don't have windows are really nice for bathrooms because, well, you know, privacy. But yeah, all of you who are currently listening, I would like to thank you again. And for showing up and hanging out, the Lord and Lady appreciates you. Or, company. Honestly, I'm not going to be using torches again for a little while. I can throw those out for the time being. Honestly, need some cobblestone and maybe some amandasite would go a nice way into making this look a bit less boring. But, I mean, sure. And the whole idea behind this part of town is that it's kind of a boring, but like, throw a little disrepair into the mix. You know. That's also fair, but sometimes making things look older or isn't necessarily a bad thing. Oops. Like, just cobblestone, and particularly mossy cobblestone, really? He give a build this kind of lived-in feeling, I think, if that makes sense. Like, it feels like it's been here a while. And that people will have, like, lived there a bit, or potentially... He, like, for Mossy, he, like, a sort of abandoned feel, like, people used to live here. Her kind of vibe, if that makes sense. Packed mud and mud brick, on the other hand. Oh, I was going to do that eventually. He myself, actually. Thing is, because I don't really have in my inventory for cracked. I'm not using the composter right now. Oh, I'm... Hey, ditch that. What the heck, might as well. I think so, but it's not something I've ever, or personally, he effed with. Like, I am not knocking it, and I'm sure it can look really good in the right context. I just don't think I have the chutzpah to make that look good. Hate it when my headphones reset themselves for no reason. And, no, I do not use shaders. I have basically never used shader. Because I haven't even used resource packs in forever. Like, you see, the thing with me is I try to make my... Hey, builds look good, or at least as good as I can make them in vanilla. And without any, extra stuff. Like, yeah, if you're using a certain resource pack or shader, because you can make almost anything look really good, or at least a lot better than it does. But not everyone is going to be using the OSA to the... And they're just seeing it, as the game presents it. And it could look like, especially if you're using resource pack, like certain block choices that make sense for a resource pack, heck, will end up looking extremely strange without that resource pack. And that's why I don't really use resource packs anymore. They're a crutch, and not a crutch that everyone is going to use. That being said, there are a few resource packs that I actually really miss. Like, my philosophy is that you should make your build look good without shaders and resource packs first, and it'll probably already look good with them, and if it already looks good in vanilla, if that makes sense. Like, just don't design your build around the use of a particular resource pack or shader. But yeah, as I was saying, there are a couple of resource packs that I genuinely miss. Like I remember using the Weiyukian pack way back when. And during, 1.12, my god, I miss that one. But the people who were making it stopped updating it. So it's just kind of in 1.12 limbo. Oh, forever. I also remember this one in freaking Candyland, one that I thought was kind of cute. It's not one that I would use seriously, but it was honestly just it's cute. Now, I believe I was mixing in Kerberstirt and Andersite. So, yep, hopefully you guys are enjoying things. Yeah, I know you guys are be pretty fun to hang out with so far. I hope if nothing else I've been interesting enough. Maybe it isn't much, but I think it was a place so slightly more run down feel. Well, it makes everything look a bit less samey. Ah, here's where I was. Thank you. Man, it would be really awkward if my mom came in and asked for my help with something right about now. Getting there. So, how's everyone's day so far? And did I miss any messages? Okay, just say about resource packs and Faithful. Faithful is nice, by the way. Somewhere else. Maybe here. Oh, later. Here's Sans. Thanks for coming. Oh, hey, someone new joined. Hello, person. Oh, Alibi. I didn't expect to see you here. It's not time for the BG stream yet. At least I don't think it is. But hello and welcome to the currently in progress City of Sanctuary. Zell! Hey. Hey, it's my favorite priestess. Hey, Zell. Well, maybe not favorite, one of, but it's not good to play favorites, kids. Oh, goodness. Let's see. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Basically, for here, reduced price houses. Nearly 100. And apartment rooms. For the bathhouse, the public toilets. Does that make you a badger, Zell? Tubular. I hate it. Tormenting you. That is too many emojis. Put those back. There. Now, I have a couple of actually important things to say to you guys. It's like, actually no joke. First of all, don't forget to stay hydrated. Hydrate before you dehydrate. Don't forget to brush your teeth. Be excellent to each other and party on, dudes. I'll just pretend I know what you're trying to say with all the... those emojis. Excuse me. Use your words, Zellington. Oh, Zell. Zell, you nitwit. I love you. Okay, can we try not to overly spam him emojis, please? I'm trying to have a legitimate conversation in here. Alright, I'm gonna go to the bathroom, but first, I'm going to give you guys a little something to listen to. Come on, load. Ah, here you are. Back in a bit. Okay, that feels a lot better. Just give me a second to get have my Snuggie back on, and then put my headphones back on. All right. What are we looking like? Oh, Zell. You got automated? I'll allow that. There we go. It's probably because you called me a monster, Zell.
Forever and forever, listen and learn. It is time for prancing. Now we are here for caramel dancing. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Okay, now for something a bit less of a joke. It is, however, equally inappropriate. Ah, nothing quite like a nice hot shower, eh, guys? Oh, that's the extended. That's enough of Winged Dragon of Ra for now. Whoops. Well, this is going to be where I'm going to have to call this for now. But I'll come back in about 2 hours. Because everyone, there's going to be another stream involving the BEG and my a deep, sexy El Norte voice. Yes. Any questions? Now, Zell probably has one question. The fuck is the BEG? And that is a completely fair question. That is a project that I am a part of. Of like, what if my friends is making an ARG and I voice a character in said ARG? Well, I say friend, he's more like my son, but that's beside the point. Yep. Thanks, I'm extremely nervous because as I have had very little time to rehearse lately. Shut it, Zell. I mean, you're not wrong. I have a lot of online kids, but I do fear being a genuine parent to an actual child. Like, the thing about the kids I have online is that all of them, or at least most of them, were already adults at the time that I adopted them. Or close enough. Like, one of the first people I adopted was, like, I think 16 at the time. Hey, man, I'm still in good contact with him. He has told me multiple times under no uncertain circumstances that I am a much better parent, a much better father to him than his actual one. So, that is something I will brag on to the end of my days. No, you're not wrong. It is kind of funny. Let's see. Yeah. You know what? Before I sign off for now, I am going to show you guys again and the apartment complex and the average room in it. Now, let me just say right now that these apartments are essentially free. Like, if you were actually living in the city of Sanctuary, these would essentially be places you could live for absolutely rent-free. And there's like 100, or nearly 100, at apartment rooms in this complex. Oh, that's so nice, Zell. I hope that works out for you. But yeah, the thing about this city, and particularly this district, is free housing. Free, or at the very least, extremely cheap housing. But, well, we can talk more about that stuff another time. For now, I need to try to rehearse and stuff and, well, yeah. Like I said, I'll see you guys in about 2 hours. As if you feel like popping in. Alright. Peace out, lovelies. See you all in 2 hours. Lol.